good evening, and thank you everyone for coming. It's such an exciting night for us. I'm very happy to be here. And to answer your question, this is a very important story to each and every South African. And I was born in the 80s during apartheid, and I grew up hearing so many stories about Nelson Mandela. And for me to be part of his story, part of his legacy, was more important to me than any other film that I've ever done. And to play a woman who the world hasn't seen, the woman that no one knows about, was a beautiful challenge, because then you get to see a different side of Nelson Mandela. You get to see the man and the younger person that most people don't know, because we remember the old Nelson Mandela only after prison. Fortunately, we worked with a very great team. Mr. Anand Singh has been working on the film for the past 16 years. The research was done. We had enough material to refer to documentaries, but with Evelyn there wasn't much, so I had to rely on the family, which they were very kind enough to open up and tell us stories that we read about, things that we never knew. And also for me as an actor, making the right choices, understanding what it meant to be a woman back then, and to be married to someone who would change the world one day, and I have no idea at the time, was exciting. I think it's one of those things that I really love about the film, because they never try to create a story of a saint or an angel. And that's one thing. I've been very lucky to meet Nelson Mandela a couple of times, and he always said, "I am not a saint, and I don't want to be painted as a saint." He was a man, and through the character of Evelyn, you get to see a man who was never perfect, but someone who was very strong, and he did what he believed was right at the time. And back then, it was okay to push around women.
Do you know what? It's people who are not sort of confined to one space. It's people who will not let the rule of the time be your only rule. It's people that have their own free will, that they have their own thinking, that they will do as they list. It's those people that if you're not subject to the rule of the time, then you sort of are the troublemaker. Fall into the line, because you knew you had something greater than that. Because once you fall into the line, you have your advisors who tell you what to do, and then your rule, and then it's all sort of... The emotional part of playing Madiba is just getting under the skin, getting to know the man at a stage where he had the potential to change the country. At a stage where we don't know him at that stage yet. He's still a 16-year-old initiate, still a 16-year-old boy who becomes a man. The man that we don't know completely, that's the man that has, it's like dynamite that hasn't been lit yet. And it's that man that is the most inspiring thing, which just means that we all have this explosion inside of all of us. It just has to be ignited. And for me, getting to learn that bit, and it's not like you sit there going, people know what's going to happen, and you're that guy that's going, people know exactly where it's going to go. I have no idea what it's about me. Maybe it's because I'm tall. Our former president Nelson Mandela was a very, very, very good-looking guy.
The media and other invited guests for this very memorable film. I feel very privileged and very honored to be here today at the launch of this film in our country. Privileged and honored because of the man that has been encapsulated in the film. His contribution to the world, to the universe, to society at large, to all people that believed in equality and dignity. And those were the things that impressed me the most. I have a long history with South Africa, and a very pleasant one indeed. And today is just a very formal moment, but I know that there have been many occasions with not just the people of South Africa, but indeed Mr. Nelson Mandela himself. I'd also like to mention that, as Sudhir was saying, we formed a very strong association for over 25 years with Sudhir and his dear friend and my dear friend, Anand Singh, who produced this film. Anand, Sudhir and myself, we perhaps had the very first concept from the Indian film industry in South Africa way back in 1990. And at that time, the country of South Africa was still reeling under the pressures of apartheid. And we were the first Indian group that were allowed to perform there. And this was possible primarily due to the efforts made by Mr. Nelson Mandela. And it was he who gave us the permission, and his party, the African National Congress, that gave us permission to perform there. Since then, of course, I had the very big honor to meet Mr. Mandela on two separate occasions, once at his residence. And those memories are with me always. He was a very generous and kind man, very humble. He signed a portrait of himself for me and sent it across to me. But really what was quite amazing and humbling was, on another occasion, when the African National Congress had lost a very prominent leader, I was in South Africa at that time, and we felt that it was only right for us to go and pay our condolences. So we drove across to the house, and as we reached the house, Mr. Mandela and his entire formal entourage was leaving the residence, and we were across the road, standing and waiting for his cavalcade to pass by. He was about to get into his car when he got out, and he noticed me across the road, and I was surprised that he would notice me. And he called out to me to ask me to come over. And as I was walking, he stretched his hand out across the bonnet of the car and said, "I hope you remember me," which was just unbelievably amazing. He was a very generous man, very kind man. The world will remember him as one of the greatest humans that we've had. I also had the honor, through Anand and Sudhir, to visit Robben Island, where Mr. Mandela was kept captive. I went to the cell where he was kept for so many years. I saw the mines that they had to work in, and the kind of hardship that he had to face. And I'm sure that a lot of that will perhaps be shown in the film. And really, it was a very emotional moment for me. And I've always felt that so long as there are human beings like Mr. Nelson Mandela alive in our universe, we have so much to learn from them, how we conduct ourselves and what they fought for, and the dignity and the respect that they left us with. I want to congratulate the makers and the artists, the two lovely artists here who have been responsible for this film. I hope you enjoy this film. It's been a great honor. Thank you very much.
Especially after somebody like Mr. Bachchan has spoken, he doesn't want to be in the spot. Well, as a South African band, Nelson Mandela is part of our heritage. So the association with this movie comes to us very naturally. It's a tribute to Mandela. And it's also a privilege and honor for us to be associated, to have been given this opportunity. I must congratulate and compliment the producers and the actors for creating this epic for us. Mr. Bachchan said a lot of things about Madiba, that's what they called him. I'm not going to say anything because I don't think I can say anything about a man who's walked such a long journey. So on behalf of the bank, we have a short 2.5 minute video which is our tribute to Nelson Mandela. That video incidentally is also available on YouTube, you can find it later. We'll play it at the beginning of the movie. I'd like to thank Mr. Bachchan for gracing this occasion.
Thanks, Mr. Bachchan, for those inspiring words. Mine is not to give a speech, but to come and thank First Rand Bank for organizing such an robust event. I think we feel so privileged to be the first ones to view this sort of feeling that dedicates itself to the life of a martyr, the life of an icon, whose spirit is always undying and remain amongst us as a motivating and inspirational word of wisdom amongst us. His life has been an epitome
of nationhood has been an epitome of caring and loving to all humanity throughout the world. And I think as we proceed to view this particular film, we'll see that in it there is a lot of edutainment. Whilst we are being educated about the life of the Mataya, we are also being entertained by the actors who have basically worked tirelessly to put this particular film together. And I think for us, we also owe a thank you to the Indian nation. Had it not been for your own selflessness, your own courage and dedication to see to it that Africa is free from the bondages of colonialism, Africa is free, South Africa is free from an oppressive regime, we wouldn't be enjoying the freedom that we are enjoying today. So once more, thanks to our friends, thanks to our fellow combatants in India, who has been side by side in ensuring that we liberate Africa, we liberate the world. Thank you and keep up the good work.